Happy New Year, everyone. We appreciate you joining us for the January 2016 edition of The Salem Connection. I'm your host, Casey Duncan, and for the next few minutes, I'll be connecting you to what's happening in your community. Salem's new city manager, Steve Powers, joined us on November 30th, and at a December 1st community welcoming event, Mayor Peterson formally introduced him to Salem. Let's listen in on the community reception for some insights into the selection process, Mr. Powers' qualifications, and a few words from the city's new manager.
That our national search, which was thorough, was intensive, was directed and focused, resulted in us finding the very finest person to be the next city manager for the city of Salem. I'll tell you a little bit about Steve Powers. He came to us with a resume that said to me, this person knew what he wanted to do when he finished college. He prepared there for his bachelor's degree, his master's degree, and he steadily walked along the trail to become a truly well-educated, well-tempered, well-experienced city leader. Community leader, and that's what I was looking for. Then we discovered him in Ann Arbor, Michigan, and when four of us went there to do the rest of our search, we found a community that did not want to let him go. And I thought that spoke very, very well of him. So I'm excited to introduce to you our new city manager, and I ask you to welcome him to your community, to bring him into your activities and your programs, and to help him really learn the heart of this great community. It's my pleasure to introduce Steve Powers. Steve?
Thank you very much. The mayor did a wonderful job summarizing my resume, but believe me, I'm gonna learn as much from you. I'm going to learn as much from those in the organization as I will contribute. I really believe this will be a team effort. I also want to thank the members of the community that are here this evening, those who are active in the neighborhood associations, those who serve on the various city advisory boards and commissions. Also, I want to thank the regional partners that are here this evening. That need for regional cooperation is so important when revenues are challenged and constrained and the public's expectations for services remain very high. So it's important to be working together as much as possible. And I shared this with the staff leadership team this morning, and I didn't move my wife 2,100 miles away from our kids in Michigan to come be a caretaker status quo manager. You know, I came to be part of a team, a policy team, a community, and an organizational team that is striving to be the best. And I'm here to help Salem become the best city in the United States. We may not get there, but the journey will be, I know, very, very worthwhile. And it will take all of us to make that journey, and we're just so thrilled to be here with you to be on that journey together. So, thank you.
You can reach Steve Powers at 503-588-6255 or via email at manager@cityofsalem.net. Did you know that 9 of your friends and neighbors joined the mayor and city council to recommend a budget for the city? The city budget year covers a period from July 1st, 2016 through June 30th, 2017. On December 9th, in preparation for their annual work, the Budget Committee was presented with a summary of changes expected to revenues and the cost of providing city services. This forecast showed that three things are helping the city in the near term. First, there are several signs that Salem's economy and housing market are improving. Second, growing property values have eased some of the recent revenue losses we've experienced due to compression. Lastly, management and staff have been tireless in their efforts to decrease costs and increase savings each year since 2008. And as a result, the city has built up its working capital. Despite the improvements in the economy and efforts to increase efficiency and save, the city anticipates that costs will escalate at a greater pace than the revenues currently available to fund services the city provides. Beginning April 13th and most Wednesdays through May this year, the Budget Committee will look carefully at the city's estimates for revenue and costs of services and capital projects to develop a recommendation to the council on the $500 million budget. You can add your voice by participating or providing testimony at a Budget Committee meeting or City Council public hearing on the budget. The budget wraps up with at least one public hearing at a June Council meeting. For more, check out our webpage on the city's budget. Throughout the year, the city actively monitors water levels in Salem's creeks, streams, and rivers. Did you know that Salem has an early warning system to alert you to high water conditions on our creeks and streams? You'll find real-time rainfall and local stream data, as well as regional National Weather Service forecasts on our website, onerain.com. You can also watch Doppler weather radar imaging on the site. Justin Boyington, Salem's stormwater monitoring analyst, recently prepared a tutorial of the monitoring system's key features.
For a quick look at a 7-day graph of stream levels, you can select on any of these links here for a particular set of gauging stations. For this example, I will select on the Clark and Pringle Creek gauges. Once loaded, a view pops up showing all of the different stream gauging stations we have on these streams. Note that up in the upper left-hand corner is the station name and a quick description on its location.
You can stay up to date on road conditions and sandbag locations by signing up for Salem's Community Alert System or checking out our emergency information page. From the top right-hand corner of the city's homepage, click on Emergencies to learn more. For this edition of the Salem Connection, we kick off the first in our series about how the building development process works in Salem. Each proposal for a future development project is reviewed by staff for consistency with the code and zoning regulations, as well as overarching plans for the community and individual areas. As the pace of development picks up across Salem, property owners are more frequently asked to weigh in on our development applications. Community input is important. To learn a bit more, we turn to Rose Walker and Eunice Kim from Salem's Community Development Department.
Hi, and thanks for joining us for the first in a series of videos to answer your questions and learn more about the development review process. My name is Rose Walker, and I'm a Neighborhood Services Counselor with the City of Salem. My role is to support neighborhood associations in providing information and resources in assisting them to improve the livabilities of their communities. Neighborhood Services is housed in the Community Development Department, where we work very closely with our city's planners.
I'm one of those city planners. My name is Eunice Kim, and I'm one of 8 planners who work for the City of Salem. In planning, we strive to enhance the quality of life for Salem residents while helping the community grow. We do this through our review of development applications, as well as the creation of longer-term plans. Development review is part of a larger process of how an idea goes and turns into an apartment building, or a new business, or a new development of some sort. And the development review happens at the beginning of the process. We look at what uses go where, the design of a site or a building, and we look at impacts on the neighborhoods around it and the community as a whole. This is where your input is critical because you have a say in the shape of the future of your community. In all of our work, we strive to provide excellent customer service. That's why Rose and I are launching this new video series. We want to provide you with information you need to best participate in our development review process. We know it can be hard to understand and sometimes figure out when and how to best provide comments when there's a development proposed in your neighborhood. It can even be confusing trying to figure out why we ask for your comments on some applications, but not on others. These are the type of questions we hope to answer in this new video series.
We've developed a brief survey for you to let us know what types of information will be most useful to help you better understand and get involved with the development review process. The survey will be available beginning this week and through January 31st. The information that you provide will be instrumental in helping us to develop this video series beginning in the spring of 2016. The survey will be emailed out as well as posted on the city's website and social media pages.
In the meantime, if you have any questions, suggestions, or comments, feel free to contact me or Rose or visit our website at cityofsalem.net. Thank you.
That concludes this edition of our show. Have ideas for future shows? Get in touch with us at manager@cityofsalem.net or 503 540-2426. You can find us on Facebook and Twitter, or get your City News Weekly by signing up for our electronic newsletter on our news page at cityofsalem.net. Thank you for joining us. We look forward to connecting with you next time on The Salem Connection.